1985, you wrote Russians. And as I said, there was a ton of questions, mainly people saying, you know, did he actually believe that we don't love our children? He says, I hope they love their children, if they love their children. Does he think that we're not human beings? And why did he write this?
In the last verse, I say, what will save us is because the Russians love their children too. You know, I was born and brought up in the West, and we were educated and conditioned to look at the Soviet Union as an ideological fortress. And also, because they were our ideological enemies, perhaps we would fight a war one day. It's easier to fight a war against people who perhaps aren't quite human. And, you know, that was a sort of tacit...
Dehumanized.
They were dehumanized. You were dehumanized. And I was aware of that, that was happening to me in the media, in education generally. And so I wrote this song in the early 80s. It was another one of those frigid times in the Cold War. We had Reagan's Star Wars, wonderful Star Wars thing to protect us. We had Rambo and on film, you know, shooting Russians up in Afghanistan. I wanted to say something that was went against that feeling. And I was very fortunate. I had a friend who worked at Columbia University. He was a research scientist. And he had a piece of machinery that could steal the signal from a Soviet satellite above the North Pole. And so on a Saturday night, he and I would go and watch Russian television. I'd never seen Russian television. Of course, it was Sunday morning in St. Petersburg or Moscow, and we watched children's shows, you know, the old version of Sesame Street or whatever. And what struck me was how much care and love and attention had gone into these programs. So clearly, you know, this idea that Russians didn't love their children is ridiculous. And that was the basis of detente. This is why we didn't blow each other up, because all of us, the West and the Soviets, had a stake in the future, which was our children. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying, you know, we love our children, and therefore we're not going to blow the world up. You know, I regret that our current ideological enemies don't seem to have the same feeling. You know, they want to blow the world up. So I kind of miss the Soviets in that regard.
I don't know if you're aware of a Russian poet called Yevgeny Yevtushenko. Mm. You've heard of him.
I know him.
Back then, he wrote a song called Do the Russians Want a War? Mm-hmm. And it was put to music by a Soviet composer. Have you ever heard of it?
I haven't heard of that song.
You haven't heard it. Okay, well then, let me put it this way. If you had heard it then, you know, Do the Russians Want a War? Question mark. What would have been your answer?
Of course not. Who wants war? Crazy people.
Europe and America, there's a growing feeling of hysteria. Conditioned to respond to all the threats and the rhetorical speeches of the Soviet. Mr. Khrushchev said we will bury you. I don't subscribe to this point of view. It's such an ignorant thing to do if the Russians love their children too. How can I save my little boy from Oppenheimer's deadly toy? There isn't side of the political fence. We share the same biology, regardless of ideology. Believe me when I say to you, I hope the Russians love their children. I hope. abortions love their children. Of ideology, and what might save us beyond is that the Russians love.